Media giant ABS-CBN receives a favorable ruling in its lawsuit against over a dozen pirate websites. A U.S. court has ordered 21 web operators to pay ABS-CBN $1 million each in trademark damages for illegally streaming the company's content. Seven sites were also slapped with additional fines for copyright infringement and cyber squatting. The operators have also been ordered to hand over their domain names to the company. ABS-CBN is the parent firm of this news channel.
Philippine air carriers ramping up their operations amid a recovery in air travel. Cebu Pacific has launched its newest Manila-Camiguin route, the first airline to resume operations to and from the Camiguin Island. Meanwhile, Philippine Airlines is now operating an average of 120 flights daily for both domestic and international flights. This translates to 40% of the pre-pandemic regular flight frequencies. Among the resumed flights are routes to Los Angeles, London, Singapore, Sydney, and Seoul. This comes after the flag carrier filed for Chapter 11 bankruptcy protection at a U.S. court earlier this year.
A study by the Asian Development Bank cites the Philippines as a country which shows the services sector can be just as important as manufacturing in growing an economy. The ADB's Global Value Chain report said, through the Philippines' participation in global services value chains, the business process outsourcing industry enjoyed massive growth, both in employment and revenue. An economist from the World Trade Organization also says opportunities in services value chains have yet to be explored fully.
Services GVCs themselves that can present massive productivity growth opportunities to the other services sectors. The argument for manufacturing GVCs was always that in a way a GVC is a new production technology that allows each player to focus on where he's best at, and that actually generates productivity increases. And we see the very same thing in services.
U.S. President Joe Biden and his Chinese counterpart Xi Jinping agreed to set up talks on arms control. The two leaders met in a virtual summit in a bid to ease tensions between the world's top two economies and major geopolitical rivals. The talks, which were initiated by Biden, were intended to set terms for future U.S.-China competition. A White House official says the need for discussions between nuclear-armed nations was also agreed upon during the more than three-hour meeting.
How our bilateral relationship evolves seems to me to will have a profound impact not only on our countries, but quite frankly, the rest of the world. We have a responsibility to the world as well as to our people. It's why we believe, and you and I have talked about this, all countries have to play by the same rules of the road, why the United States is always going to stand up for our interests and values and those of our allies and partners.